Welcome back to Vikings basketball with head coach Barret Peery. As the Portland State Vikings season is now underway, as we record this, Portland State 1-1 on the season and just a couple of days away from a contest at the University of Hawaii. And then on next Wednesday, the Vikings home in a big crosstown rivalry game against the University of Portland. And coach, before we talk about those games real quickly, let's kind of recap where we've been. The Vikings have practiced for about 6 weeks. The season got underway. You've seen your team play a couple of games, and evaluate what you've seen so far.
You know, I really like where we're at. We're still trying to get guys healthy, and you know, recently got guys eligible as well. But we started off with a scrimmage with New Mexico, a good team that we faced and played very well against. A couple home games that everybody was able to see, and then most recently at Indiana. I like who we are. I like the style of our team as far as how they play and what we do. I was proud of us Saturday. I didn't love the score, but I was proud of us Saturday as how we handled the environment and the situation. We had some good opportunities to make that game very, very interesting and played well. With our new guys, you know, they're getting opportunities to get experience in our system and how we play. And guys are really fitting in well. And we have good experienced guys that have returned that have really made it easy for them.
All right, as the Vikings season has begun, they're integrating 8 new players on the court actually playing. And I know, Coach, a couple of things you're looking for this year. Number one, improved shooting over last year. Number two, I think you probably feel that this new group of guys perhaps a bit more athletic and even more suited to your style. And as far as those two elements go, what have you seen?
Yeah, you know, I think in year three, you and I have talked about this behind the scenes a lot. The roster fits us the best it's fit, and it's a roster of guys that we've chosen. And so we have guys that I think have been able to come and fit what we want to do, both on and off the court. But a lot of new guys, but an emphasis definitely in the offseason was shooting. We've got 3 or 4 really good grad transfers that have really, you know, molded themselves well into it. Chris Whitaker, a junior college transfer that's playing good minutes for us. Kamani got hurt, so we lost him for the season, another transfer. And then, you know, guys like Trey Wood, who's redshirted last year, guys that have been here but didn't play yet. Kyle Greeley, been here but didn't play yet. Those guys are getting opportunities now, and they look like they know what they're doing. I'm excited.
All right, and the Vikings, as we look back at the first two games, a convincing win over the University of Puget Sound, no surprise there. And then a rugged contest at Indiana University against a team, obviously from the Big Ten, a power conference, a much bigger team, a much more physical team. But I think you probably feel pretty good, despite the fact you did not win, the way your guys handled that experience.
Yeah, our guys showed very well. You know, we're down 6 with, you know, 10 or 11 minutes to go in the game and had an opportunity to a couple different times to make it really, really interesting. Their size was just awesome for them. I thought our guys would have trouble with it, but, you know, it was one of those deals when I came out for the game and saw their guys, I kind of said to myself and the staff that, hey, they're even bigger than I thought they were, you know, and I planned on them being big. So I thought we had some really good defensive segments in the game, but couldn't get finishes with just simply rebounding the ball. I was disappointed during the game about how I thought we weren't blocking out. Sometimes I thought we blocked out really well and just couldn't get it. So our two guards, Hauser and Bubu, really played well, and we need them to play well every night. But, you know, those guys really did a good job in controlling the game and making shots. We didn't do a good job finishing around the rim when we needed to and make some big plays at the end to get it really interesting and get it into a 1 or 2 possession game. It kind of stayed in that 10 or 12 mark, and we couldn't do what we wanted to do at the end.
And kind of leads right into my next question. I was going to say, a couple of guys that you are expecting a lot from this year, Holland Woods, Matt Hauser, lots of points you're hoping to get from them, good shooting. And when it came up against a real quality opponent, they showed well.
They did. They really, and you know, they have great experience. They're two guys that have played a ton of college basketball, and I wasn't worried about them. I wasn't worried about our team, you know. Sal and Zoe, I thought, struggled a little bit in that game with the size and the length, but Sal's been banged up and Zoe's been banged up. We really need to get them healthy. Rashad did a good job. Chris Whitaker did a good job. So the team played well, but we weren't able to finish some plays the way we needed to. But when we're healthy, I think we have a really good group.
All right, let's take a look at the next two opponents. A quality opponent out of the Big West, the University of Hawaii, coming off a really good year. They are 2-1 already, and I know they have some pretty decent size as well. Vikings going to make that trip to Hawaii. Coach, got to keep the guys' minds off the beach and in the basketball arena. Challenge there?
Yeah, I'm scared to death about it. You know, I actually just was sharing with them as we left practice today that Aaron Rodgers clip from about 10 days ago when they went to LA Chargers now. It's still San Diego, but when they went to San Diego and played the Chargers, LA and played the Chargers, and just didn't show up because he thought they maybe had been out, you know, worrying about other things too much. So we got to turn into a business trip in a hurry and get serious about what we're doing. Hawaii had a great win last night against Pacific. They're 2-1, like you said. They have very dynamic guards that can score the ball and good size as well. So we'll have our work cut out for us.
All right, and then the big game, the game you need to come out and watch on Wednesday, November 20, Portland State hosting the University of Portland right here in the Viking Pavilion. Portland State has beaten Portland 3 years in a row. I know you haven't lost to them yet in your first 2 years. And the Vikings go into that game with a 9-game home winning streak. And, Coach, the first question is this starting to feel like the Vikings' home?
Yeah, we love being home, and it is. You know, last year at this time, I really felt like, you know, you and I talked a lot about it. We were all trying to feel how it would be and get used to it. Now we're used to it, and it feels like home. We're excited about it. We're excited to have Portland coming. They're doing a good job. They already have a really good win at San Jose State over the weekend, and they have some good returning guards that have played a lot of minutes for them. Terry's got them ready to go, and I think they'll do a good job.
All right, and people like me talk about it being a big game, but crosstown rivalry, does it maybe have a little more importance to the coach, to the players?
Yeah, I get excited for it. I think the players do too. All the players know each other so well. They see each other a lot in the gyms around town, in the off season, playing games. And yeah, and I try to feed the rivalry as best I can because it's fun. I think everybody should enjoy it and have a good time with it. And I think Terry feels the same way. You know, we've spent time together talking about it. I think it's good for both programs, and I think the city gets excited.
All right, last question. Tell us now, we're probably about 6 weeks away from conference play. I know the season has just begun, but what are you trying to accomplish as we lead into Big Sky Conference play over these next 6 weeks?
You know, one thing about it is, you know, like I've said to you all summer, we have a lot of experience, but we have a lot of newness. And so I think this preseason is crucial for us to get experience together, have our guys play together, go through these games together, these trips together, and get as good as we can be preparing for January 1, you know, when conference comes around and when it really is important. I think we have a great preseason schedule that will prepare us, as well as games that are winnable, teams that we can beat, teams that we can compete with. I don't think there's anybody on our schedule that we can't compete with and play with. And so I'm excited to take these guys on the road and at home and compete with teams.
All right, there it is. The Vikings, as they're getting into the meat of their preseason schedule. They play at Hawaii on Friday night, and then the big one here Wednesday, November 20, against the University of Portland. For all your information on Vikings basketball, go to govikes.com.